Hello Sudoku players! In this video, my number 2 video, I will demonstrate my strategy to solve the Sudoku puzzle. A lot of Sudoku teachers talk about techniques to solve the Sudoku, and there is a long list of techniques, and the more difficult the Sudoku puzzle, the more techniques you need to have to know. But I give you, besides techniques, also the strategy to solve a Sudoku puzzle. That strategy consists in these 3 layers, I should say. First layer, we start always go from 1 to 9 and look on the 3 squares, vertical and horizontal, for naked and hidden singles, and at the same time for naked and hidden pairs. The singles we can immediately fill in, the pairs we note in little figures. Second layer, we look for the squares, columns or rows of 9 figures where the lowest number of lacking numbers has to be completed. For example, we have a row with already 6, 7 or 9 numbers. There we start to fill in 3, 2 or 1 lacking numbers. Therefore, we need to handle the technique of recognizing double pairs and triplets. To be successful, we need a third layer. We need to use the 2 former layers through each other. So now I'm going to demonstrate in an easy video, easy Sudoku puzzle, my techniques. But first we start with number 1. Number 1, and we fill in the lacking number 1s or the pairs. In this we have only 1 possible square to fill in the number 1, and that's this one. We have other also here in this square. The only possibility to fill in number 1 is here. And then we can go further. Where do we fill in the number 1? Here, here we have a pair of number 1s. Here we still have a pair of number 1s. And here we have a pair of number 1s. Number 2. With number 2, we look here. And then there is only 1 possibility to fill in the number 2 here. And then, because of this number 2 and this number 2 and this number 2, there's only 1 left here. And then we have to look here on the first column for a number 2. We have to look better here because there are only 2 squares left. And then the number 2 should be here. Yes, and that implicates that we have a number 2 on this side, and the last one we have here. So, and then the number 2 is already completed. Number 3. Number 3 in this first square. We have here number 3s and there. So then the only square left that's a naked single is here. In this square we have here a 3, here a 3 and here a 3. It means there is only 1 square left here, and that we call also the naked single. And then we have, in this square, we have here 3, here 1, here 1, and here 1. So then the only one left, square, the naked square, is here. We have a number 3 here. And the last number 3 shall be here. Here in the corner. But because of we have here a pair of number 1, if that is the number 3, that should be the number 1. And on the other side, then there is one number 1 left, and this here. So we have already 1, 2, and 3 filled in. Now the next one, number 4. Number 4, we have a pair here. In this square, we only have number 4 left. It's very easy. And then we have a pair of 4 here. Let's have a look. We have also a pair of 4 here. And then the in this square we have only here a pair of, because of this 4 and this 4, we have a pair of 4 here. And this one we have everything filled in as possible. And then we see that here there's only 1 4 left to fill in. And then you have to know also, in this square, you have a 4 here or a 4 there, and a 4 here or a 4 there. So in this row can be a 4, in this row can be a 4. So the only 4 we can put in this square is there in the corner, is a 4. And then we go to number 5. Oh no, we have already still a 4 to fill in here, but the other ones we have to wait. Now we go to number 5. Number 5, we can have a pair of 5 in this square. Let's have a look. Yes. And then in this square we have here a pair of 5. We have a 5 here over 5 here. Then there should be a 5 here or there. But because if we have a 5 here, this should be a 5. Then we go to number 6, or now we can fill in also the 5 here. Oops. Then we go to number 6. Number 6 in the highest squares. This should be here a 6. And then we have only 1 6 left here, and here we have a 6. So the only left is here, and then all the 6s are filled in. Number 7, we only have 3 for the moment, but have a look. Here there's only 1 lacking, number 7. And then we have here only 1 lacking, number 7. And then we have here, because of this 7 and this 7. Here, only 7 lacking. It means that we have here 7 lacking. We have here, because of this 7 and this 7. We have in this 7. We have here 1 7 lacking. Because of the pair of 4, it needs to fill in with a 4. And another four, we have all the fours when we filled in this one. We were with the seven, let's have a look. Seven, seven, there is only one left here, seven here, seven here, seven there. This should be also the last seven. Yep. And then we go to number eight. Number eight, we can fill in here a pair of eights. We have to look here. This is only one eight left. And then we have here a pair of, we can fill in the double pair. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That will be 8 or 9. So we can fill in here 8 or 9. And then number 8, let's have a look here, then we are here with 8, the only one for 8 shall be here, and then there is only one number lacking, that shall be the 9. Yes, and then we can see because of this 8 and this 8, there's only one 8 left here. Then we can fill in the 8 there. So the only 8 we can fill in is here, and that should be a 9. We have all the 8s, and then we go to the last number, number 9. Number 9, we can fill in here. We have a double pair, you could say, of 5 and 9, but here is already a 9. This one will be the 9, and this one will be the 5. And then we have only one left here. It should be 5 or a 9, but here we have a 9, so this should be 5, and this will be the 9, and then we are cleared. So this was it for today, and thank you for watching, and have a good day. Bye bye.